Hello and welcome to the Dynamic Ocean Surface tutorial for RealFlow. In this lesson you will learn how to move a vessel over a virtually endless ocean. Instead of a huge fluid tank, we will be using a dynamic ocean segment that moves with a ship, and this way we don't have to create millions of particles we'll never see. For this project I have imported a model of a typical tugboat into RealFlow. Currently the object is locked and can't be moved, scaled or rotated. Make the boat editable with File to Curve and move it to its starting position. The next step is a definition of a surrounding fluid container. An open cube is perfect for this purpose. Rename the object to Container. The container has to enclose the entire distance the boat will finally cover. So here, scale is 100 by 50 meters and height is 6 meters. Now we are going to create the ocean segment by adding a standard cube. Rename it to Ocean Emitter. The cube's width equals the container's width of 15 meters. The height axis determines the scene's water depth, and 1.5 meters are good here. Make sure that the cube encloses your ship and that there is some space for the bow and stern waves, so a size of around 30 meters is appropriate. In order to create a dynamic ocean segment, we have to animate the emitter object. Extend the simulation range to an ease, for example, 400 frames, and add a key at frame 0. Then move the object to the last frame and create another position key. Of course, the boat should move with the ocean segment, and to do this, parent the boat to the ocean emitter node. Now it's time for the Hybrido scene elements. Add an emitter and attach the ocean emitter. The associated domain will be created automatically. Select the emitter and activate its stream function. This option will constantly create new particles during the simulation, but currently the problem is that stream will be filling the entire container over time. To fix that, add a K-volume daemon and place it behind the ocean emitter node. Take care that a part of the daemon's box intersects with the ocean emitter object. Now set inverse to yes, because we only want to delete particles inside the bounding box. Then create a copy of the daemon with clone selected and move it to the opposite side. Finally, parent the daemons to the ocean emitter to make them follow the rig. We are almost done, and the last node is a gravity daemon. Okay, we are ready to simulate, and the first impression is pretty good already. Anyway, there are a few things we can change. To get a better resolution and more detail, decrease the domain's cell size. For stronger waves, I also recommend playing with vorticity boost, and here, particle sampling control is not necessary. But the number of particles influences the quality of the mesh and secondary elements like splashes. And to get more particles, go to the emitter sampling values. In our case, only the surface is of real interest, so change surface particle sampling to 3. The boat cell size should also be checked, and the Hybrido interaction parameters can help to shape the waves. And now it's time for the final simulation. As you certainly know, RealFlow's command line is a perfect tool to accelerate simulations. So activate it, reset, and hit simulate. And this is what we get. The biggest advantage with our method is that we only simulate what we really need. Furthermore, container and emitter object can be resized on demand, and you can, for example, fit the ocean segment into a camera view. Secondary elements like splashes and foam can also be adjusted to the ocean segment. Thanks for watching and have fun with RealFlow. Goodbye.